We're definitely going back to stock up on essentials. However, important question number one. Can I call a vertibird here, or are we walking? That's the wrong key. Don't do that. Let's get far enough away from the house so that we know there's no obstruction. Come on. Come on, vertibird. Yes! Yes! Oh, I know, I'm a lazy person. I don't care. And we're back here at the castle where I have been restocking, resupplying, and basically preparing for the trip that we are about to go on. I have done a number of things here, including visiting the doctor and being cured of all the various things that were ailing me, which were many. Oh, I tell you what, before I go anywhere, let's just check. Do I have a Nick? Yes, he's following me. I'm using power armor. Okay. This seems to be fine, right. So yeah, I got the doctor to cure me, but I also took one rank in chemist. I can actually show you that. I took one rank in chemist. I think it's under... Yeah, there you go. So that I could make chems, and I made some antibiotics, which I think is going to be, you know, pretty useful. I can only make 5. I need glowing fungus. So, anyway, yeah, so I'm cured of all my problems. Well, all my medical problems, and I now have antibiotics. I've also lightened the load and changed my weapon loadout a little, which I can't show you here. Well, I suppose I can show you in my inventory. Instead of my sniper rifle, I've decided to bring the pipe bolt action rifle of exploding. I converted it to 50 cal. Now, there's two reasons for this. One, I wasn't all that impressed with my hunting rifle. I really wasn't. I think the two-shot things just does not work. So whilst this does a little less base damage, I actually think it's going to behave as well, if not better, than the hunting rifle purely as a weapon. But it also has exploding, which is not bad. It does 15 points of area effect damage. Now, of course, I double that with my perks, and I double the area of effect, which was going to make this pretty devastating. It is also half the weight. I've got it specced out reasonably well, and it is about half the weight. So that saved me a little bit of, carry weight. Because it's explosive as well, I decided not to bring my shotgun, my exploding shotgun. And the reason for that is that thing's bloody heavy. That was huge, as was the ammo. I'm still bringing my plasma rifle. I have now brought a lot more ammunition for this because this is going to be my primary weapon. The only other thing I have brought is a 10mm pistol of exploding, and I brought no ammo for it. The only reason I brought that is it's quite light, and I have no idea how long we're going to be gone, and I might need a backup weapon. And I figure 10mm ammo is pretty common. That is a very good weapon. I stripped off all the heavy mods, but assuming I can find a workbench, I should be able to improve it, perhaps even make it an automatic. I have been thinking of taking some ranks in automatic, you know, so I can use submachine guns. Although, again, that means I use more ammunition, and ammunition weighs something. Maybe I should actually take some ranks in pistols. Having pistols for close-up might be the way to go. You know, plasma pistol, exploding pistol, and then have a rifle for long distance. Might be the way to go. Now that ammo weighs quite a lot. I have brought 6 fusion cores, excluding the one that's in my powered armor right now. I have brought all the food I could make and all of the purified water that I had, which was about 15 bottles, which means I should be okay for about 40 minutes or so, because, you know, for some apparent reason, I'm like a fish. I pretty much need to live in water. But that is all I had. So, we're stocked up. We've got stim packs, we've got food, we've got water, we've got antibiotics, we've got falling cars again. I swear there is somebody who's pulling these cars back up and throwing them off, because at the rate I see falling cars, there'd have been no cars on this bridge pretty much within about a month and a half of me leaving the vault. I mean, that's how many cars I've seen thrown off. Oh, right, yeah, I remember that. Oh, I almost forgot to mention, I set up provision routes for the two new settlements. I used automatron robots. In fact, I actually sent Jazargo to one of them. So we've got Jazargo wandering the wasteland, the Commonwealth, with provisions. So maybe we'll run into him, which would be kind of cool. I also made a very, very large sentry bot with tons of Tesla coils and called him Boris. That's my other provisioner. He looks kind of terrifying. This...
Looks like a good landing spot. I'll have you on the ground shortly.
Okay, only just. Getting close to having me in the water. What was that? It kind of looked like a rad scorpion for a second, but I don't think it actually was. Don't steal their bucket. Okay, it's a monument. I did not see that when I was last here. Is it a grave? It has all the hallmarks of a grave, doesn't it? Kazumi's holotape to Grandad. It's Grandad's grave. I'm supposed to have come up this way. I've been very disrespectful. I'm supposed to come walking up here. Probably not in power armor. That's even more disrespectful. Let's listen.
Grandad, I know you can't hear this, but I can't think of a better way to say goodbye. You've taught me so much, and I won't forget any of it. I'm sorry that we'll never be able to fix up the old clunker we've got sitting in the boathouse. Wherever you are, I hope you're at peace.
Okay. Out of curiosity, do you think there were any other... I know. I'm just looking for things we might have missed. Flowers? No. It's like, you know, we were going to fix the old clunker. That meant boat, right? Not... Okay, what the hell is that? Is that a one-seat pickup truck? That's kind of interesting. Anyway, I think that's it. We're ready to go. We are on our way. He says, what do you bet the boat's going to explode? It is, isn't it? Are we taking the cat? Are you a cat person? You look like a cat person. I have to admit, I could imagine you with a pet cat. Even a synth cat. Like a Gen 2 synth cat with half its skin missing, like you. That would actually be kind of terrifying and cool. You could pet it. It'd make you look a little evil. But honestly, that might not be a terrible thing. Give you a bit of, you know. Okay, the control. That's the controls. That isn't. That seems a little odd. We're going to drive by paint. Yes, I do appreciate you probably don't drive a boat. Oh, those are the controls. That makes more sense, doesn't it? We pilot boats, don't we? We pilot. Fine. Okay. Ready for takeoff. Travel to Far Harbor. That sounded a little off, didn't it? Like, have we got like a pet Deathclaw underneath swimming for us? Okay, that would actually be kind of cool, wouldn't it? Can I move around now? Oh, I can! I don't need to keep steering. Oh, it's autopilot. Nick! Okay, let's hope he's a good swimmer. little worrying. Is that? Okay, it looked like that ship was floating. This looks a little creepy, doesn't it? Seriously? Was that a wolf howl?
Put the damn gun down.
Okay. Nick! Okay, you caught us up. That's good. Do you need a towel or... Hello? Please don't shoot us. We're very nice.
Lost? This is Far Harbor. We don't get many visitors around here.
We don't need no freeloaders or more help, Mainlander. So you can get back in your boat and leave.
Alan, this isn't your dock. It belongs to the whole town. And that means strangers are welcome. Sorry, you've caught us during a difficult time.
Walk in the park!
Alan's got a point. Not all visitors have good intentions. So, what's your business here?
What's the... I need information about a synth refuge. It didn't come all this way to me. That's a bit nasty. A young woman from the Commonwealth named Kazumi may have passed through here. I think honesty is the best.
A young woman from the Commonwealth named Kazumi may have passed through here. Her family hired me to find her.
Some sort of detective, huh? Well, she came through here all right.
At least we know she made it this far.
Okay. What?
Damn it. Mariner's incoming.
What's a mariner?
You, help us defend the town, and I'll answer any questions you have.
Defend
the post at the top of the wall near the main gate. The hull never lets us down. Now follow me.
The hull never talk
hull,
to the.
Stranger. Don't fall off. If you do, we might not be able to rescue you.
Don't fall off. Don't fall off. Okay, we're not falling off. What? We've got to follow you. Here. Okay.
Down the hull. Something's out there.
Something's out there.
You sure you saw something?
What's...
This ain't a drill.
Okay, that didn't sound.
Eyes peeled, everyone.
That doesn't look.
Open the gate. I've got wounded out here.
Mariner, there's no time. Look to the fog. They're coming.
Look to the fog. Okay, what's in the fog?
Oh God! Defend yourselves.
Oh.
Okay, I'm gonna guess that's...
Let's do this.
Have I got a silencer on this thing? It feels a bit...
What's that?
Oh, God. Okay, young gulper... Oh, God.
Hunter, look out!
Legendary mile... Okay. We got a legendary... Whoa. Can I? Should I use explosives? There's people down there. Oh, God. There are people down there.
No. Eyes on the fog. Something's coming.
Something's... Okay, you know what? I'm just shooting it. I hope that's good. Oh, I'll tell you what. This weapon doesn't... Legendary go, but this weapon does not... Fire as quickly... Where are they?
We're clear.
All right. Well done, all. Open the gate.
Okay. What were the... Oh, did you just drop down? What the hell were these? Gulper innards. Plus stuff. Young gulper. Chest butt. Oh. Yeah. Terrible person. Oh, I suppose we should go and talk to people before we run around looting. Hello? Was it Captain Avery?
Avery.
And now you see what we're up against. The fog and the creatures it spits out have taken the whole island from my people. And for your help when we needed it, you deserve this.
Okay, wait, what's the fog? I mean, you do say it with, like, a capital letter.
What's the fog?
Where to begin? The fog's radioactive, right? But there are pockets of it, the deep fog, that are hard fallout. And as deadly as that is, that's only part of the problem. Things live in the fog, thrive. You think what attacked the harbor's bad? Oh, there's far worse further inland.
Okay, you've lost the whole island. Everywhere I go, nobody's got it easy. This is actually true. Although, let's not... If you manage to despite all that, you must be tough. Let's be nice.
If you manage to survive despite all that, you must be tough.
Ornery, more like.
I'm done cowering behind your damn hull, Avery. Time you let me deal with the real problem. With the right people and my guns, I can end those Children of Atom cultists for good.
The fog's been here forever.
Oh, God. Really?
The children didn't make it.
Before the Rat Eaters came, the fog was under control. They come, and it all goes wrong. It's time we do something.
No need to burden a stranger with all this nonsense.
Sounds like you should deal with the Children of Atom permanently. Well, I've had mixed dealings with those guys, so let's hold off on the let's kill everyone plan. What's the deal with the Children of Atom?
What's the deal with the Children of Atom?
They're religious folk. Worship the power of Atom. Which is radiation, I guess. If you want details, you'd have to find and ask them. We used to have a peace with them until a certain hothead menace named Alan Lee...
Now that's enough. That preacher came into the harbor saying that it was Atom's will that we lost our land. That it was Atom's goddamn will that we lost so many friends and family. And that the Atom would wipe this whole place clean of us.
If it were up to me, you'd hang for what you did to that preacher, Alan.
What did you do to the preacher?
What did he do to the preacher?
Alan pulled a gun on him. He claims the preacher reached for his. We don't have police, or really any law. Just custom and popular sentiment. And after everything the preacher said, it was abundantly clear doing anything to Alan would have made matters worse.
Right, so, difficult to know. Maybe the... I don't really know enough about the Children of Atom to make a decision on that one. Not that they're asking me to. Okay.
Have the children made the fog worse?
Absolutely not. There's not one bit of evidence.
Geiger counters don't lie, Avery. The fog's gotten more lethal year over year. And now the fog's covering the whole island. But only after the children came.
You know as well as I do, that's happened
before. Correlation does not mean causation.
Sure, people have theories the children are involved, but no one, and I mean no one, has proof.
Although, to be honest, Children of the Atom, radiation going up, it's sort of convenient, isn't it? I can see why people would think this. Can we get back to... Sounds like you should deal with the Children of Atom permanently. I don't think so. Can we get back to business, Liz?
Can we get back to business?
Sorry for all that. You're here for Kasumi, right? She headed inland to the Synth Refuge, Acadia. Getting there will be dangerous. You'll need a guide. Old Longfellow. No one knows the fog like him. But word of warning, he's a bit of an acquired taste.
Okay. Can you tell me about him?
What's Old Longfellow's story?
He's the best hunter on the island. Fearless. Some say crazy. If someone needs to get to Acadia, he's the only one that'll do it. But people around here are known for being stubborn, willful, and other less flattering things. But Longfellow's got a reputation even among us.
Okay.
What can you tell me about Acadia?
Ask Longfellow. He's the only one that's been there.
Okay. I don't need a guide. No, I'm happy to have a guide. Thank you very much.
Thanks for the info.
I probably need one.
Best place to look for Longfellow's at the bar. The last plank. And, please, lend a hand around town if you're able. Even if it's slapped away, people like the Mariner and Cassie and others need help. And let me say something you might not hear again. Thank you.
You're welcome, so I should...
Guns, guns, and more guns.
guns, guns, and more guns. I will be talking to you in a little while. Before we do that, living on the edge. Help the citizens of Far Harbor. Optional, help Cassie Dalton, help the Mariner. I think helping people is a good way to basically, you know, getting up in everyone's estimations and have them trust me and give me more information. Plus, it's the right thing to do. Complete delivery of the egg or return the egg to its nest. Okay. Walk in the park, talk to old Longfellow, living on the edge. This is just generally help everybody. Are there any miscellaneous ones? No. Oh! God! I totally forgot to tell the... I totally forgot to see the railroad about... Oh. I was going to go and see the railroad and see if they had any information. Maybe I should nip back. Okay, this is Jared Gresham.
Hey, toss anything you can't haul my way.
Yeah, I'm just going to take some of the stuff out here because, you know, what is that? What is that? Do they keep the beasties away? Obviously not very well. Armor. Sturdy armor of a chameleon. Yeah, no. But I'll take it. Although God knows where am I going to put this. So yeah, I really did want to talk to the railroad. They might have had some decent information. Okay, radiation in the fog. Okay, and... Yeah, sorry about this. Seems a little disrespectful. Oh. However, survival is something you just have to constantly do. Right. Can I?
Captain Avery's alright, I guess.
Nick?
Hey. Over here.
Can you go over there? Can we close the gate? Can I get out of my armor now? I mean, am I safe-ish here? Let's have a look. There's an armor repair bench. That is going to be kind of useful. I can even take all this? That's interesting. What was this place called again? What was this place called? It's literally called Far Harbor. Right, so this is the main city. Let's just wander around and talk to everyone. Alan Lee.
Alan. Huh. The mainlander. Great.
Fire your gun a few times and you think you're some sort of hero? This is our fight. Our island. Not yours.
Don't you want a helping hand? I'm the one that said no. I was just trying to help. I really was.
Hey, buddy. I was just trying to help.
Charity makes you weak. Makes you need it more and more. Until you're starving from the lack of it. What happens next time when you ain't here, huh? For the next. Either us Harbormen survive on our own terms, or we take the long walk together. So if you're here to buy some ordnance, do your business. Otherwise, take the first boat out of here. Before the children of Adam or worse get you.
I'm not interested. What's your problem with the children of Adam? Yes, tell me.
What's your problem with the children of Adam?
We should have gunned those bastards down the moment they set foot here. Instead, we let them in. All in secret from wherever they're holed up. They've been feeding the fog. Getting it stronger. Strong enough to push us all out of our homesteads. Further and further until it's a wonder we're not all drowned in the ocean.
Okay. Do you have any... Come on.
Do you have any proof that they've fed the fog?
Why do I sound all echoey?
We wait for that and we might as well pull the trigger ourselves. Look. My daddy's time, the fog was a nuisance. Something you avoided. Now every day it gets stronger. It's like the fires of hell out there. Because of the children.
Where's the thing? I don't know. Not interested right now. I don't. Barter, show me what you got. Here's the thing, though, dude. I've got to tell you. I'm not convinced you're right, but you might be. Here's the thing. If anyone can figure it out, it's me. Science, my thing. Nuclear physics, my thing.
I'm
like...
Make it fast.
A regular boffin. Let's have a look what you have. What is that? It's a harpoon. I can shoot harpoons?
It's 35 caps? Are you kidding me? And what's that? That's a great big hook. 40% less action points, and it's... Okay, dude, why is it cost nothing? Because it doesn't cost nothing. What the... It costs 312. I'm looking at this wrong, aren't I? Let's have a look at this. Oh, my bad. I've got to get used to this again. The value is down there. This number is how many you've got. Oh, wow. It's been a while. It's actually been a while. They're not really that expensive, though, are they? This thing is a harpoon gun. The Admiral's Friend does double damage if the target is at full health. I have to own one, don't I? But where am I going to store? I could give it to Nick. Can I store things on the boat? Do I have a storage on the boat? I gotta buy it. I need it in my life. Yeah? Okay, I do. Right. What else have you got? Lever action rifles? The fish catcher? Pipe revolver? A lever action rifle! It uses 45-70 round? Really? Oh god. Yes, I may be a little too excited, but what is a radium rifle? See, my voice is going. I'm like a kid in a sweet shop at Christmas with his parents' credit card. That's a really badly behaved kid, that, isn't it? Okay, harpoon gun. I've got a legendary harpoon. Did any of them have those weapons on them? Did I pick any of these weapons up? No, I didn't. There was a hunting rifle and that was it. Oh, God. Okay, to be honest with you, I think I shouldn't buy whilst so damned excited. We might find a lot of these weapons. Okay, I'm hungry and apparently thirsty, and my health is a little low. Does food actually give me health still? I don't know whether it does. But I am hungry, so I need to eat anyway. Oh, so I'm going to be able to use this to make food. This is good. I was also thinking, should I make soup? Is that, like, going to, you know, best of both worlds sort of thing? Mutt chops. And I also want a drink. Purified water. Should have brought some Nuka-Cola. I can't believe I forgot to go and speak to the railroad. Let's have a look. Oh, it does still give me some... Why have I got... Am I gaining health that slowly? Really? That is pretty incredible. I'm also... sick. Or whatever that thing is. Adrenaline is up. Peckish, parched, purified water. Oh, no. The purified water is actually giving me health back. That's not sick. That's... Okay. Still parched, still peckish. Okay. I will take some more. Food. Mutt chops. I get a little message, don't I? I think I get a little message. Yeah, properly hydrated, so I need... I suppose it was a long trip. Okay, properly fed. Ah, there we go. There's my health back to... Okay, is the weather getting a little better? Yeah, before we start randomly buying everything under the sun... I can use this, can't I? Yes, I can. Excellent. Brilliant. I'm going to leave it like that just because it looks neater. As long as I can get out. Can I get... Yes, I can. It still looks... Oh, God, you know what? It looks even more creepy. It looks... seriously creepy. Fresh... Lobster. Fresh lobster. Really don't want to accidentally shoot anything with this. Okay, so water and food still heals me, which is going to be useful. We have another shop. Hello, Harborman. So no. By the tourist shop. Hello, Captain Avery. No. Okay. have spoken to you. This is a fish shop? A market, a general market. Brooks! Hello! What the hell is that? Oh, it's a fish head. Never mind. My bad.
Excuse me.
Welcome to the bait shop. If you need any odds and ends, I'm your man.
What's your story? I might be looking for something. It's very
true. What's your story? Just a guy trying to make a few caps. Speaking of which, buying anything?
I might be. Yeah, no, I might be. I might. I'm not sure. Oh, yeah,
let's see what you have.
Let's see what he's selling. He is selling ammo, which is always good, I suppose. It's nice to know I've got a good selection. At fusion cores, in case I run out. Purified water, probably going to need that. Am I not? Steel, I can't quite remember what that is. Oh, lever action rifle again. Suppressed. I want a lever action rifle so very badly. Poached angler. Okay, no. Recon marine helmet. All right. So, yeah, worn ribs, vim. What is vim? It caffeinates, probably keeps you awake. I like that idea. Shipment of concrete. I've actually got a lot of that stuff now. Jet. I have to say, these traders are actually remarkably well stocked. Sandra Lee, hello.
Hey there.
Mariner says the fog's alive. Can hear you. So mind what you say.
Yes, I wouldn't want to upset the fog. Okay, so that was you. This looks like a doctor. Probably going to need your help, aren't I? Several times.
You another vulture circling over Andre's body? He ain't dead. Wait.
Who's Andre?
It's a mainlander. Well, welcome to my little clinic.
Who's Andre?
If you need doctoring, speak up. I wish I had time for some proper conversation, but my work's never done.
No problems here. I need some help. I probably don't need any help at the moment, although I'm gonna see what you're selling. But who's Andre?
Who's Andre?
Poor Andre is my patient over there. He spent too long to spell in the fog. You may think you know your mainland radiation poisoning, but we got our own special brand here.
I know a few things about medicine. I've got one rank, basically, but...
I know a few things about medicine. Can I try to help him?
You say, what? You... help? Well, poor Andre's got it bad. Good as dead. Well, I suppose there's no harm letting you have a poke. But I'll be watching.
Yeah, no. No, I... The thing is... The stupid thing is I could improve my doctor skills somewhat here. I really could. Because, of course, I still have one perk. I could take another rank of medicine. Would it be worth it to save a man's life?
Let's take a look.
Intelligence 8 or medicine 2. I've actually got... Okay, Andre McCord is suffering from prolonged severe radiation exposure. He's barely clinging to life. Intelligence 8 or medic 2 required to heal him. I am very intelligent. I've got chemistry. I'm great with radiation. I don't need to be that good as a doctor to cure this. Excellent. Nice. Using blood plasma, Radaway, and anesthetics, you managed to stabilize your patient.
Well, I'll be.
Yay!
I think you may have done.
Yay!
I'll keep looking after Andre. But I think thanks to you, he's got a fighting chance.
Oh!
Welcome to my clinic. You need anything?
I might. Let's just see what you got. Let's see what he's got.
Let's trade.
Works for me.
Okay, so starting with... I saw something very interesting. Antibiotics. Herbal... antimicrobial. Oh, right. Yeah, no. I can make this stuff, but the problem resist infection and parasites. But it requires something I don't have. Was it a... I'll figure that out. Let's buy some of this. In fact, let's buy all of it. Let's buy the antibiotics. I don't know how much I'm going to need, but I, you know, I've... How many have I actually got? Oh, please tell me I brought... Where are my antibiotics? Oh, there they are. Five. I got five antibiotics. I've now got six. This might be useful. It probably will be. He's got purified water. Again, like I said, they're actually surprisingly well stocked. I might even buy some junk if I can sort of get a settlement or anything. That would be nice, wouldn't it? If I get a settlement, though. You know what? If I get a settlement, you know what I really want to do? I want to go back and get it connected here and then go and talk to the railroad. Okay, so we've... Can I talk
Andre.
To
him? Jean. No. No.
Okay, I don't think he wants to chat. All right. Win it.
Teddy.
Is this a social visit or is something alien?
It's more of a social one. No, that's okay.
No problems here.
Lucky you.
I was just going to ask who he was talking to. Right, well, we've done one good deed. Who are you? Are you probably just a wanderer? Right, what have we got? Information. Is that Far Harbor or Bar Harbor? That looks like Bar Harbor to me. Was this place originally called Bar Harbor and someone misread the label? Just say Bar Harbor. Am I misreading the label and it's actually... No, it says Far Harbor. It does say Far Harbor. Is there a signpost outside saying, "Welcome to Far Harbor"? Probably. There's a story there. Souvenirs. We've got... The last plank. You know, I've just realized something. I've spent almost as much time exploring Far Harbor, the town. Oh, God. I've got... Auto hotkey! Annoying me. I've spent almost as much time... No! You're not boiling him alive! No, come on!
In the deep fog. Things out
oh,
there.
Oh, come on! I mean, I eat them too, but I don't boil them alive. Oh, man. Yeah, I was going to say I've spent more time... Almost as much time exploring this place as I have Diamond City. Cassie Dalton. Oh, I've got to talk to you. I'm going to talk
You're
to you in a minute.
You're the mainlander who just got
Harborman.
Here.
Fisherman.
Need general supplies?
Harbor woman.
Visit the bait shop.
Harbor woman.
Hey, mister. Those aren't your boots.
They're on my feet.
Mariner says the island.
My brother's been through enough. Those boots aren't yours.
Sony's got no right to be here no more. You can't take care of yourself. Better you take the long walk.
I'm giving you one warning. Tony gets his boots back.
Your mom's not around no more, Smalls. I'm not afraid of you.
Are you afraid of me?
I'm just a stupid girl, thinking you can take me. But everyone's got to sleep. Make things right quick. Or else.
Shit.
Did you give the boots back?
I don't need your charity.
I was going to offer to help, but oh my god, you're scary. Small Bertha.
Bertha.
You still here for some reason?
Just wanted to say hi. Okay, apparently I didn't. Tony!
Well, hello.
You're from the Commonwealth, right?
Yeah, why do you remind me of Trashcan Carla? Okay, the last plank. Alright, so nobody out here is going to talk to me... Apart from... Hello, Cassie!
Mrs. Dalton.
You're that mainlander who just got here. Better watch yourself, because this island sees and hears everything you do. I should know. I watched the island tear down the greatest family that ever set foot in Far Harbor. It's a tale of greed, blood, and vengeance.
Sorry, I'm not big into stories. Sounds interesting. I'd like to hear it. Of course it would.
Sounds interesting. I'd like to hear it.
I thought you might say that. My family, the Daltons, was the pride of Far Harbor for generations. Even back before the war, it was lumber and fishing that made the Daltons rich. But they got greedy, took too much from the island. The island's been getting revenge ever since, killing us off one by one. I'm the last Dalton still standing. Ah, but now our story takes an unexpected turn. A mysterious stranger comes to Far Harbor. Someone strong, someone capable. With the stranger's help, the last living Dalton finally has a chance to avenge her bloodline once and for all.
Okay, wait, are you saying I'm the mysterious stranger who's here to help you avenge your family? The that would be the stupid statement. I get it. I'm the stranger. You need my help. Fine, but you better make this worth my time. Cut the bull. No, let me guess. I'm the mysterious stranger who's going to help you avenge your family. Yes, of course she is. Of course she is. I'm almost tempted to go for the third one, but let's be polite.
Let me guess. I'm the mysterious stranger who's going to help you avenge your family.
Ah, you're a quick one.
You don't have to be that quick to get
that
one.
You'll need your wits about you, because your part in the story is filled with danger. Now, on to the first chapter in our tale of vengeance. That would be the sad story of Freckle-Faced Petey. Petey was my cousin. He was a good lad, never caused trouble. He thought all those freckles brought him luck, but, well, not so much. He was out foraging at the National Park campground when the island sicked some feral ghouls on him. Island's a sneaky bastard when it wants to be. Anyway, he made it back to town, but died from his injuries that night. Of course, those ferals are still out there, waiting to kill the next poor fool who comes along.
Where did you say the ghouls were? Yeah, go on.
Where did you say these ghouls were?
National Park Campground. It's pretty much straight west of here.
Straight west. Okay, I'll take out feral ghouls. Definitely, I mean, if they're a menace to the village, to the town anyway, they should probably be dealt with.
Those ghouls are as good as dead.
Good, good. It's long past time those shamblers paid for what they did to Petey.
I don't really think of it as a justice, to be honest. It's more like protecting the town at this point, isn't it? I mean, they don't really have a brain. Well, is that awful? Am I racist against feral ghouls? It's just... Well, they're feral. I mean, it kind of goes with the territory, doesn't it? You know, now I feel terrible. I'm still going to go and shoot them, but, you know, I'm going to feel terrible about it inside. Hello? Old Longfellow, I've got to talk to you.
Everyone! Everyone!
We're trying to have a conversation here.
Shut your mouths! Open your damned ears! So the fogs are coming for us all, and I can't see any better way of greeting it than to have another round. On the house!
Yeah!
Time to party!
Okay.
It's Mitch!
Mitch!
Mainlander, today's your lucky day.
Apparently.
Free beer for ya! Ha ha!
Okay. Do you have anything a bit stronger? I'm curious as to what they've got.
You have anything a bit stronger?
Pushing your luck, are ya? Ha! I like it. Take this. Top shelf all around. So, drink up!
Okay, just vodka.
Stay here over long and the fog will claim you. Might as well meet her with a belly full of fire, eh?
Okay, rent room. I'd like to rent a room. Do I want to rent a room? I don't think I want to rent a room. I'm probably going to want to rent a room and sleep sometime. I'll come back eventually. But,
what's so special about the fog on the island?
Can you feel it? Even here, as safe as anyone can be on this damned island. It's alive. You walk inland and it'll blanket you up in no time. And if the clickety-click of the Geiger don't get you, the madness will. The island will claim us all in the end.
Okay.
The fog can drive you crazy?
Yes. It's not natural. The trappers you find inland, some were always murderous louts. But many just got lost in the fog for too long, and the mind goes. If you have any sense, return where you came from, and don't look back.
You know, that just doesn't suit your face and outfit. You need to be a gnarled old fisherman with a beard and a woolly hat, maybe a hook or something. You're not supposed to be a young guy with a leather jacket on. That's old man sailor story, that is.
You are mighty good at listening. Too good.
This is wrong. Okay, anyway.
If it's so dangerous, why do you stay?
This is our home. If you call yourself a proper man or woman, you don't give up on that. Besides, we all gotta die. Might as well do it with your long knife deep in the belly of the beast that wronged you. Ha!
Okay. I want to see what he's selling.
I could use a drink.
He might be selling something useful.
Music to the ears.
Okay. Purified water. Vim? I've got to learn to make that. And that seems to be about it. Dirty water. I can make other things with this. I'm going to be buying a lot of liquid, I feel. So, okay. Right. So, Debbie?
We're the only bar in town.
Something wrong with your eyes. You bit bloodshot?
Excuse me.
What's your order, sweetie?
I'm thinking about it. What do you have to drink?
All sorts of old world booze. We carry Vim, too. And before you ask, Vim is an Islander favorite. But it may pack more punch than the stuff you're used to.
Okay. Let's have a look.
What you have.
Certainly.
Same stuff, right? Okay, but it's good to know.
Too sober, by my estimation. I can fix
okay.
that.
Okay, Harborman, Harborwoman, Nick. Now, I've got to talk to Longfellow, but that's for basically walk in the park, talk to old fellow. I need to help the Mariner. Where is the Mariner? Let's have a look. Local. That's old Longfellow. Help the Mariner is outside. Let's go outside. Before I talk to Longfellow and get wandering off, I'd like to just help the people out here so I've got some friends. A, it's the right thing to do. And B, as I've said before, it's the sensible thing to do. So. 10.
The whole took
the Mariner!
To be sure. But she wouldn't be standing at all if it weren't for you. They call me the Mariner, shipwright, handyman, and the only one keeping the harbor afloat, beside Captain Avery.
Okay, why doesn't anybody help you? The town's lucky you're here. It is, it's really lucky you're here. Why doesn't anyone help
you? Why doesn't anyone help you?
Each harborman is the captain of his own ship. Worked fine for generations on the homesteads. Your land, your rules. But when the island pushed them onto my dock, one by one, the ungrateful bastards expect me to look after my land, even though they're squatting on it like wretches.
Okay. Is it, if it's that bad, why put up with it? Well, no, because she's putting up with it because it's the right thing to do. She's ornery, as the captain would say, but, you know.
The town's lucky you're here.
You blowing smoke up my sails? There is. I don't suppose you'd be willing to lend a hand.
Oh, yeah.
In order to do proper repairs, I need tools. Specialized tools. And they won't be easy to come by. 450 caps if you can, though.
So I'd be risking my life. Oh, of course, right. Why do you need special tools? Sign me up, I'll help. But why do you need special tools? Just...
You've kept the walls together this long. Why do you need special tools now?
I want to build the hull up proper. Make it strong. And keep those blasted crabs out. Good.
Nope. I will do it. And I'm not going to ask for more money. I'm going to help everyone out.
I'll help.
Eagle's Cove Tannery. Tools are certain to be there. Now get.
Okay. So I've got a number of things to do to help the people here. I also still have nowhere to sleep or store things, or do I? Can I store things here? Do I have any storage space? No, I can go back to the Commonwealth. Really, I can't store anything anywhere. But I've got so many things I want to buy.
Oh, and I'm the type of guy who will never settle down.